My name is Richard Bridgeland. I'm a production designer. I think in French you would call me a chef décorateur. I worked on The Nice Guys, Sherlock Holmes, Game of Shadows, Rock and Roller, Alien vs. Predator, and Resident Evil. I did not know One Piece before I worked on this. Luckily, my kids educated me on One Piece. This was really a job of translation, translating it into real life. And when you do that, it has to be relatable to people. And I treated it a bit like doing a science fiction film, where you would take a period and then you project it into the future. And here I took the world of 18th century piracy and I projected it into the fantasy world of One Piece. I did a lot of research into pirates and galleons and the whole 18th century world and the architecture of it all. We went to Oda and said, "Oda, is there electricity in the One Piece world?" And he'd never thought about it. And he was quite taken aback and said, and he said, "Well, I need to think about this. This is a whole new idea." So after a couple of days, he came back and he said, "I thought about this." And he said, "Yes, no, I think there's electricity in this world." But it was a big deal because it was a part of the world he'd never thought of. But because why should he? Nobody actually said whether he did or not. So if he did, it was a secret. The place that I was most excited to design was the Baratie restaurant.
What's up, Baratie?
It's such a kind of unique place. In the manga, it is depicted as this kind of a sort of pyramid structure on top of a ship, and it's got a big fish mouth on it. Most exciting of all was the dorsal bar, which I decided to put inside the fish's mouth. And it made, I think, the most unique bar I've ever seen anywhere. I think there should be a theme park with these places in. The interior of Kaya's mansion. They don't appear in the manga. In that part of the story takes place outside of the mansion, and you never see inside. So this was actually a real challenge to create things that the fans had never seen before. And the only thing that I knew about Kaya was that her grandparents had started this famous shipyard where they built lots of the pirate ships of famous pirates in the One Piece world. So I figured that the pirates would have paid for their ships, not just with cash, but quite often with the cargo that they had in the hold. So we end up with a dining room that is covered from floor to ceiling with fine porcelain and plates. There are corridors that are filled with sort of wonderful curiosities from around the world. And then the dressing room, actually one of my favorite sets, is a room just filled with clothes that might have been the cargo from a pirate ship that they'd stolen. And so you have clothes covering the walls and hanging from the ceiling as well. Made for a really unique look, but also gave it a history, but also felt very kind of One Piece as well.
Hey, Zoro, what you gonna wear?
Something black.
Nearly a year and a half's work to achieve the first episodes. This was kind of old school filmmaking. All the ships were built, all of the settings are built for real, and they were big sets. It was a bit like doing four big feature films back to back because every two episodes you moved to a different part of the world. To create a fantastic sort of new world like the world of One Piece, we wanted people to believe in it. We wanted the actors to believe in it and to feel immersed in that world so that the world had, touch and smell and texture. And to do that, you really need to build physical sets. Oh no, all the food was real. Oh, absolutely. Devil fruit, I think, was made of marshmallow, and I think the outside of it was made of marzipan. So they were all real and they were all edible. J'espère que les décors vous ont plu.
Depuis que je suis enfant, j'entends l'appel de la mer. Du coup, je me prépare à réaliser mon rêve. Le roi des pirates, ce sera moi! Pour ça, il me faut un équipage loyal. Et toi et moi, je suis sûr qu'on formerait une super équipe. On s'élance sur la route de Grand Line.
Une zone dangereuse de l'océan, où les îles sont plus grandes et les pirates plus puissants. Fais un peu attention.
Je suis pas sous tes ordres.
Il y a un peu de tension dans mon équipage, j'ai l'impression.
On n'est pas un équipage.
Notre équipage est encore tout frais. Mais on se fait entièrement confiance. Go, Mega! Pistol! Tous les grands guerriers gueulent le nom de leur attaque finale.
Non, c'est faux.